very much, everybody, for inviting me here today. My name is Sidra Nain. For those of you who don't know me, I am His Majesty King Charles' Deputy Lieutenant for the County of Essex. And my role is to represent the King's interests and dignity of the Crown in our county. I'm privileged to be either directly involved with or get to see a very wide range of activities. And it is an absolute honour to be here today at this Essex Faith Covenant Gathering 2023, because there's been quite a few, hasn't there, now? The Essex Faith Covenant, as you already know, is a joint commitment to a shared set of principles that guide engagement between faith communities and public services. It aims to promote open, practical working and strengthen community cohesion. This work was demonstrated recently at the very successful Beliefs and Blue Lights Conference, which was held at Chelmsford Cathedral. I'm actually just returning from an awards ceremony, which I'm ecstatic about, because it's all fresh and new. But did you know this award has got something to do with the Essex Faith Covenant? Because Women Together, which is the organisation which is also the South Essex cluster of Essex Mind and Spirit, were both one of the very first signatories to the Essex Faith Covenant. And did you know that the people who gave me this award, which is the Basildon Activity Award, they are actually also part of the Faith Covenant. And did you notice when I spoke about Women Together that they got in touch with me? Hence, this award is actually through the Faith Covenant, how I ended up getting this. So it's very interesting. And this award is for Basildon Activity Award for Women Together for Strengthening Communities. Like I said, both Women Together and Essex Mind and Spirit are the original signatories of the Essex Faith Covenant. And it was through the Covenant that Active Essex made contact with me. And this is actually a perfect example of a faith community working with a public service and strengthening community cohesion, which is exactly what Essex Faith Covenant is all about. So what a night for me to get this on, and then to come here straight after. I think it was just meant to be, wasn't it? So, in this particularly troubling time where politics are a source of division and conflict, it is even more important to have organisations such as the Essex Faith Covenant, which provide a unique opportunity to foster understanding, respect and appreciation for the various faiths and philosophies that are within our communities. I have seen the Faith Covenant grow in number and in strength over the years. And I'd like to commend Andrew really for this, because since he has come on board, I have recently seen a huge, you know, interest, and it's really has been strengthened, and the number of signatories have grown as well. So let's give Andrew first of all a big clap. Commend the chair, Ivor Moody, and the vice chair. Is it vice chair Stan as well? If you two want to stand up, let's give them a clap. Still been talking about it for the last 2 years and nothing's happened, and the other one hasn't even started yet. So we are actually far ahead with the Essex Faith Covenant here in Essex. We're far ahead than other boroughs. So together let us work towards a world where diversity is celebrated and the values that underpin our faiths, love, compassion and justice, become the common ground on which we stand. Through dialogue and collaboration, we can create a more harmonious and interconnected world. We look forward to the rest of the day as we look around, and where we can also use this time to engage in meaningful conversations, to listen with open hearts and learn from one another. By doing so, we can build bridges of compassion and dismantle the walls of ignorance that may separate us. I'd also like to say thank you very much to Friday Hospice as well for welcoming us and hosting us with lovely smiling faces, both of you, talking about it. Okay, thank you very much, everybody.
Here, and
I can't believe I got here on time, but God made it possible for me because mine was the first award. So then I got the award and I ran out the door. Otherwise, I would not have been here.
Okay. So am I right in thinking, Debbie, you're going to take a group down to